Before we get into today's topic, I want to make you aware of the following. If you were hoping that I talk about things like one-shot abilities, for example, because who does not hate getting one-shot, right? You are going to be disappointed. However, I did dedicate a video talking about what you might have thought that today's video is gonna be about, and that video is called 5 Most Unfun Abilities in Overwatch and Why They Exist. So if you want to check that one out instead, card can be found in the top right corner of the screen. But today's video is dedicated to all the girls and boys who suffer through competitive play. A few days ago, I opened up a poll for people to vote on the following question. What is the worst thing one can do on ladder? People could choose between one-tricking, not joining voice chat, being toxic or whiny, and smurfing. The original intent was for me to put down my personal top 5 worst offenses, but since I wanted to account for people disagreeing with me, I left the 5th option as other. Now, the point of today's video is not to just count down all these things, because I think it is quite obvious why competitive players would dislike most, if not all, of these options. But instead, I want to use these results to base today's video off of. We're gonna take a look at the votes, trying to figure out why people vote for one more than another, and how all these things relate to each other, and how they relate to the players and the game in a greater sense. While that may sound a bit complicated when I lay it out like this, it's just about me trying to make sense into the result of this poll, so in essence, it's actually quite simple. And you know what else is simple? Earning extra cash and gift cards with Swagbucks. Swagbucks allows you to earn rewards simply by taking research surveys, playing games, or shopping online. They have reached out to me to promote their service to you guys, and you can get a $5 sign-up bonus simply by clicking the link at the top of the description box for this video. So don't wait any longer and start earning extra cash by following the link in the description below. Thanks to Swagbucks for helping me keeping the lights on so I can continue putting extra time into videos like this one. Speaking of which, let's get right into it. If I was to create a player profile based on the results for this poll, it would look a little something like this. The average competitive player has one-tricked at least once in the past, whether as an experiment or otherwise. They don't always feel like joining voice chat, they own at least one alt account, and they absolutely hate when people get toxic or otherwise whiny. What you will notice when I show you the results on screen is that toxicity and whining wins by a landslide. There's nothing else that even comes close to it. Meanwhile, one-tricking comes into a rather comfortable second place, with everything else kinda just trailing behind. What I want to address here is the other option. I went through the comments people left to accompany their votes, and the general consensus was that people voted for other as either all of the above or as throwing. I didn't add throwing into the list because I wanted to bring up points that players don't have a unified opinion on. I think anyone who's even remotely sane can agree that throwing is a bad thing, but all the other points are kinda left up for debate, and that's what we're gonna do. Because what's really interesting about these results, and what helps me trying to read into them, is not just the amount of people that voted for something, but the comments they left justifying their choice. Judging by the comments, most people voted against toxicity and whining because it does two things that are very crucial. For one, it kills team morale. Players who are demoralized don't feel like playing and subsequently don't give their best. Secondly, it takes away the last bit of fun you could have had with the game, even if you were on the losing side. So players agree that it's a practice that not only lowers your chances to win objectively, but it also simply makes the game unfun to participate in. But here's where things get really interesting, because if you take a look at the comments that people left to accompany their vote of not joining voice chat, a bit of a different story unfolds. Many players who voted for this option agree that they are fine with toxicity or otherwise rude behavior as long as people try their hardest. Now, I want to show you a short clip I took off of XQC's livestream, and I know you may or may not like XQC, but this is not about him as a person. This is about what he had to say in regards to this topic specifically, so listen in.
Most of the players that climb are the people that want to win, are people that want to improve, and the people that will take the criticism and will take the emotion and insults out of it, and will get the juice inside of it. But the newbies, they'll always stay stuck on the outer shell of the orange, the peel, the insults, the garbage, the shit, the toxicity. They'll only focus on that, and they won't focus on the juice that's inside, the improvement.
So, according to XQC, players who are truly competitive care about one thing and one thing only, improving to win more matches. Which makes a heck of a lot of sense. In my last video discovering the depths of why Blizzard might be nerfing what I consider to be the wrong heroes, I also talked about how somebody with a truly competitive mindset won't handicap themselves for the sake of challenge. All they want to do is win. And if we were to take XQC's statement at face value, then there are a few things we can suggest based on the results of our poll. And not only only XQC and I have said similar things. Again, remember what a lot of people said who voted for not joining voice chat to be the worst. They too value anything that helps them win over not hurting somebody's feelings. But now look at the order in which their four main options rate. The least amount of people care about smurfing. Shortly after that, we have a bunch of people who really hate when others don't join voice chat, and then there's one tricking. But even one tricking is incredibly far off being toxic or whiny. The reason the overwhelming majority cares so much about a more positive and less whiny environment is because most of us have already accepted competitive play to be absolutely broken. Only few people believe the latter to be a place of true competition. We think smurfing is fine since most of us have a smurf account anyway, because we get tired of losing elo over things we can't control on our main accounts. We think not joining voice chat is okay because we know how annoying and whiny people can be when things don't go quite their way. And even one tricking in the grand scheme of things is not that big of a deal to most of us, given that playing our favorite hero can provide at least some level of enjoyment. How many of us can honestly say that we never tried one tricking a hero on a smurf account without joining voice chat because we just felt like doing it or wanted to see what happens? It has largely been accepted as a common practice because players lost faith in Blizzard fixing anything after they already declared that all these things are perfectly fine. They explicitly said that while they believe that teamwork and communication are the key to victory, smurfing, one tricking, and not joining voice chat are all perfectly acceptable on ladder. If even the developers show no intention of furthering competition in their own competitive environment, then it shouldn't surprise us that the camp of players who want to support that exact thing is dwindling by the day. But the one thing that the majority of us still wants to support is, well, having as much of a good time in a broken system as we can. Much in line of a, we gotta play with the cards we are dealt sort of mentality, players are saying that things are bad enough as is without us getting on each other's nerves by being unnecessarily toxic or whiny. We can't force Blizzard to create a better environment for us, but we can talk to each other and try to get us to not be such douchebags. Not to mention that toxicity is the one thing that Blizzard is doubling down on. It is the only thing on the list that they are actively working against, so it should come to nobody's surprise that the focus on this point is reflected in the player base. Another thing that's interesting to note is that, while most people voted for being toxic to be the worst thing you can do on ladder, a lot of them also left a comment saying that one tricking was not too far behind for them. So, much in line of how somebody being whiny or toxic ruins whatever little fun is left in the game, players being selfish and enforcing their pick onto others is also very much frowned upon. Now, all these things are very speculative, of course, the sample size in the grand scheme of things is rather small, but I do like to suggest that most people who watch my videos actively are actually very concerned about competitive play. So while I may not have a million and two votes down on this, I think that most people who did vote are actually part of the core competitive community. But again, this was just me trying to draw conclusions based on this poll and certain trends I've observed in the community. If you did cast your vote earlier this week, then let me know down in the comment section below how right or wrong I was in trying to read into why you voted for whatever you did. Is it true that voting for not joining voice chat makes you an inherently competitive player who only cares about improvement and victory? And would you say that voting for toxicity and whining makes you somebody who just tries to salvage what little fun is left when playing on ladder? I'd be very curious to know whether or not I hit the mark on these. And a big shout out to everyone who did cast their vote. This video would literally not have been possible without you guys. Thanks as well to Swagbucks for sponsoring today's video, don't forget to check them out down in the description below. But until then, thank you everybody so much for watching, don't forget to drop me a like on your way out if you enjoyed the video, subscribe if you want to see more, and maybe share this video with a friend you think would find it interesting. Thanks again for watching, and I hope to see you all next time.